Today's lecture on IP security. Main concepts in this IP security or overall review about this IP security. First one is IP security overview. Next one is IP security architecture. Authentication header, next encapsulating security payload. Combining security associations, next key management. These are the topics in IP security. First one, IP security overview. So this is the standard internet communication protocol is standard communication protocol. IP is completely unprotected. In general, this is completely unprotected. Modify the data in transit, adding that's why adding some IP security to the system will resolve this limitation by providing some strong encryption mechanisms as IP security. So encryption mechanisms are integrity, authentication, and replay protection and next application and another application security specific security mechanisms are examples for specific security mechanisms discussed in the previous session. Yasmin, PGP, Pretty Good Privacy, Kerberos, SSL, Secure Socket Layer, and HTTPS. These are the security IP security mechanisms are used in this IP security. So first one is this is the review or overall IP security overview. Next one is IP security architecture, right? So IPsec document overview or architectural representation of this IP security. So this architecture diagram is the combination of ESP protocol and AH protocol. ESP protocol is encapsulating security payload. ESP is the encapsulating security payload protocol. Next one is AH protocol. AH is authentication header. Right. So first field or first one is architecture covers the general concept, security requirements, and mechanisms defining the IP security technology. Main requirements for providing the security. Next one is ESP protocol. ESP protocol consists of an encapsulating header, and trailer consisting of an encapsulating header and trailer to provide encryption. Next, authentication header. Authentication header is an extension header. To provide message authentication. So here we are providing the encryption and authentication algorithm. Encryption in the sense that different types of encryption algorithms are provided by the ESP protocol. Authentication header protocol is providing the authentication algorithms like MD5, HMAC, CMAC and MAC algorithms. And combination of this encryption algorithm and authentication algorithms, these are combined in the domain of interpretation. DOI represents the domain of interpretation. So this one contains the values needed for other documents that related to each other. And this include identifiers for approved encryption algorithm and authentication algorithms, as well as operational parameters such as like key lifetime. This is the combination of authentication and encryption algorithms and key lifetime. All these things will be maintained in the domain of interpretation. Last one is key management or internet key exchange procedure. This one short it is called as IKE. Internet key exchange, a collection of documents describing the key management schemas for the use of IP security. What are the key management techniques we are used in this IP security architecture? The data will be maintained in this key management. Okay, so next topic is, after completion of IP security architecture, next one is authentication header, AH protocol representation. So authentication header format is this one, right? In this one we are having the this frame format representation. Total size is 32 bits. Here we are starting 0 to, so that's why 0 to 31, right? And in this authentication header format provide, so what are the fields here? It is next header, payload length and reserved. So payload length in the sense that how much length of the message will be specified in this payload length field, and this is the next header representation. Next reserved, so some bits are reserved for future uses. And next one is security parameter index, sequence number and authentication data. So in authentication data is the combination of the variable representation, confidentiality and integrity. And here this main functionality of this authentication header first one is support data integrity and authentication. Next functionality is, it is used for the applications or end-to-end users also. And next functionality prevents address spoofing, attacks. prevents address spoofing attacks by tracking sequence numbers. This authentication header is mainly based on the MAC function, message authentication. Here we are using the different types of HMAC, MD5 algorithm, ORR, HMAC, SHA-1 algorithm. So in these algorithms must share a secret key. This is the review about the authentication header. Next concept. In the previous slide, I am showing authentication header after completion of authentication header. Next one is encapsulating security payload. So encapsulating security payload here. Size of this encapsulating security payload also 32 bits. Here what are the parameters, security parameters? Here same as our authentication header, security parameters index, sequence number, and this field or layer is different from the authentication header. Here payload data is variable data is in some encrypted format, right? So next one is padding 0 to 255 bits. And here we are having separate two fields, payload length and next header. Payload length in the sense are here the functionalities. For example, given message plain text or message sizes, for example 62 bits. Here data is transmitted in the fixed formats. For example, data transmission capacity sizes are either 64 bit or 128 bit or 256 bit in this format. So that's why here, for example, message size is 62 bits. We are adding additional 2 bits, 62 plus 2. So total length is 64. So here PAL length specifies the how many number of bits are added for this message. For example, text size is 65. So this 65, this is round up to 128. So that's why here we are adding the additional padded length is 63 bits. PAL length is added. 63 bits PAL length is added. So that's why here we are specifying the PAL length. Next one is authentication data or authentication variables, right? So and main encapsulating security payload functionality, here it is message content confidentiality. And limited traffic flow confidentiality. And can optionally provide same authentication services as AH. Support range of ciphers, modes and padding, including here supporting algorithms are DES, triple DES, or C5, IDEA, CAST algorithms. All these are the some specification for the plain text, and some specified length is specified in all these algorithms for the key length. That's why here we are adding the some padded length. So plain text message is in the range some 62 bits or 64 bits. So differentiated from one algorithm to another. So that's why here we are another field is pad length is added in this encapsulating security protocol. Right, next one is next topic.